response to the recent sabotage attempt and arrest of the culprits, I am ordering all Pathfinder operations to be suspended and all leaf suits to be locked away until project completion. The suits are too powerful to fall into the wrong hands. Additionally, I am requesting all evidence of the sabotage attempt, including Private First Class Edwin Hall's own leaf suit and Miss King's recordings, to be gathered and sent to storage until a proper military tribunal can take place. Until then, all suspects will remain in detention. With the recent increase in production, it should not be long.
April 24th, 1943. What is the significance behind these colossal statues found throughout the valley? I find they all look so very voracious. I keep returning to the idea of the mythical Saiteka, the legendary tribe of cannibalistic giants that roamed North America and came into conflict with the Aboriginals. But why would they be worshipped here? There must be something else to it. Wendigo, a fierce creature with an insatiable desire to consume flesh. The creature is most often linked with both greed and famine, acting as a balance of nature. Why would this creature hold such a strong cultural significance to them? Built by the Susurians served as a ceremonial structure exalting the Colossi. Along with the Titan tree and daemons, they intertwined to form a mythology. From what I gathered, the Colossi were once humans who feasted upon the forbidden fruit, corrupting them into giant monstrosities, cannibalizing their fellow man and devouring all life within the valley. Is this a tale of caution? Are the Susurians warning us against abusing the power of the life seed? Mm.
Valkyrie Pathfinder squad with testing out the Lake Skipper upgrade for the Leaf suit. The lake near the Astra facility should prove ideal for the assessment. I expect a full report on my desk as soon as testing is complete.
Thank you.
mass destruction without the structural damage incurred. By extrapolating the mechanics of the leaf suit's god hand to a larger scale, I have devised a weapon capable of stripping all life from cities, even entire nations when used with the life seed. The Thanatos cannon will be the optimal super weapon, rendering all others obsolete. These bombs we're all competing to produce will look paltry in comparison. You have no idea what's at stake here.
They're embryos. The orbs you've been using are daemon eggs. What you're doing here is...
God! Since we had to catch the saboteurs in the act, we allowed them access into the Astra facility during their night of attack. Admittedly, their plan was rather genius. Since Astra and Soma are linked, they intended to fire the Thanatos cannon connected to Astra's thermal storage at the Soma facility's energy reservoir to create a feedback loop of amplifying intensity until the system blows out. Not unlike a microphone to a speaker. Operations will resume exponentially. If the orbs will not suffice, then we'll use the damn valley itself! in their hands. Remember what I accomplished. And the Braum Astral Bomb. The power to control the world will lie within the hands of a small few. Every nation on Earth will tremble.